Although this video is titled Chelsea versus Bournemouth, it's more about the day trip, really. As you can see, I started from Eastleigh Station. We've got a rating on accessadvisor.net. We're now catching up with the video, and this is a sped up version, as if you couldn't tell, of the trip out of Waterloo. I have to say, the staff at Waterloo are always very helpful. They get to the train on time. The ramps are usually always there when I go through. Here we are now, just getting out of Waterloo. What we're going to do for this trip, I caught the train and then the bus from Waterloo. Again, you can visit accessadvisor.net and we'll have a rating of Waterloo Station. I've got the GoPro camera strapped to my chest, and you can see the kind of difficulty that you get lower down when you're walking through lots of different various crowds at various places. Anyway, there's my rating of and other people's of London Waterloo Rail Station on accessadvisor.net. And now it's time to go straight out of the station. It was a lovely day, so that really helped, I think. We go out the station, turn left, and we're going down towards the bus stop. Buses seem to be very good in London. I do read reports where people can't get on the buses, but personally speaking, I've not had a bad experience for quite a while now. When I get to the bus stop, the drivers are usually helpful, and it's easy to get on, fairly easy to get on, as you'll see in a minute. So here we are at the bus stop. This is the 211 bus to Waterloo. The ramp comes out, and it's time to get on the bus. Doors open, up the ramp. Now here's the difficult bit. You can see the bar was in front. It takes me about a 75-point turn to get into the bus. But once I'm in, I feel fairly safe. And we know where we're going because I've checked the journey out beforehand. So, here we are at Fulham Road stop. We're making our way, not towards the ground, but stopped off for a bit of lunch somewhere on the way. And now it's time for the game. You can see the pavements were quite dodgy in places, but as the road was closed, we got on the road. Narrowly missed a cone there, thanks to a helpful steward. Walking towards the ground, and we'll cut this bit out in a minute and move straight towards Chelsea. This is Stamford Bridge. Passing the sniffer dog check, lovely dog by the way. Moving on up towards the ground itself. Still quite a few crowds. Past a line of stewards, and a very helpful steward takes us towards the accessible entrance. There's a gentle slope up towards the accessible entrance. And once you're at the top, it's time for a ticket check. Take the tickets, put them through the reader, pass that one too, and in we go. And now, over to the viewing position. Chelsea have got a few new viewing spaces this year, and I must say, the viewing position I had was vastly improved from the last time I went. You can see that the view is good. Don't worry about the camera. Here's one of the smaller toilets in the ground. Yep, the view is good, and eventually people move down off the seats. But lovely day. Shame about the result. And there's a review of Chelsea FC on accessadvisor.net. And then it's back home, really reversing the journey. That's all for now. Hope you've enjoyed this video. There'll be another one along soon. Bye.